योगः कर्मसु कौशलम्।
Namaskar friends, once again I welcome you to this online refresher course in English language teaching. I am very happy to learn about your interest and progress through your messages, inputs and discussion forum. Today we are going to discuss very important part of English language teaching, that is theories of language learning. The module is prepared by Dr. Dilbar Gulistan and it is presented by Nitin Pillai. Dr. Dilbar Gulistan is working as an assistant professor of English in the Department of Information and Communication Technology, Veer Narmad South Gujarat University, Surat. Her research areas include ELT, communication skills, soft skills, and modern British poetry. She has to her credit a book published entitled The Classical Strain in Philip Larkin's Poetry. She has several research papers at her credit published in national and international journals. She was the key resource person for training teacher of English in the Karmayogi Talim program by Gujarat Council of Educational Research and Training, Gandhinagar. She delivers expert lectures at various levels in colleges and institutions of state and national repute. I would like to introduce the presenter of this module, Nitin Shankar Pillai. He is an assistant professor at Faculty of Business Administration, GLS University, Ahmedabad. He earned a Master in English, that is called MA, from St. Javier's College of Ahmedabad. It is an autonomous college. He did his postgraduate diploma in teaching English, that is widely known as PGDTE, from EFL University, Hyderabad. Currently, he is pursuing his doctoral research in the area of language assessment from Gujarat University. His MPhil was in Higher Order Thinking Skills and Language Assessment from Kadi Sarva Vishwavidyalaya, Gandhinagar. He has also been awarded an online certification in Language Assessment from University of Maryland, Baltimore. He has presented papers in national conferences and has published research papers in reputed journals of national and international repute. His professional experience extends over 9 years of teaching postgraduate and undergraduate students at different levels. He is also an examiner for language testing conducted by British Council since 2015. He has been awarded for his outstanding contribution to education by the Indian Council of Literary, Social, Education and Cultural Research. He is also the recipient of Justice Ibrahim Sheikh Award and Srimati Shardaben Kharawala Gold Medal for Excellence in Education. He is involved in academic committees, extracurricular and co-curricular committees and placement committee at GLS University, Ahmedabad. Second language learning plays very crucial role today. See, when we talk about English in India, it's almost second language learning. Especially in India, where there are multiple languages spoken and where English is learnt as a second language. If I talk about myself, my mother tongue is Gujarati and English is second language. I don't know exactly about your first language, but I guess for most of us, the first language may be our mother tongue. It may be Marathi. It may be Konkani. It may be any language. It may be Hindi. And English stands as second language. And as it is, when we talk about English, it is one of the official languages. It becomes necessary for us to learn that language as well. The module is entitled Theories of Language Learning, Second Language Acquisition. It includes the detailed understanding of second language and various theories given by linguists. For better understanding, clear distinction between first language and second language, they are also highlighted with illustrations. Moreover, the module consists of behaviorist theory of L2 acquisition, mentalist theory on language acquisition, social theories and its impact on second language. So these are the theories we try to cover in this module. The module also includes SLA theories and its implication in classrooms, stages of SLA, and child second language acquisition versus adult second language acquisition. Because they are different. When you are children, when you are small, you acquire it in a different way. And when you are grown up, you acquire it in a different way. So we talk about these theories also. The last section deals with the varied ICT tools. They are useful for acquisition of languages. Finally, the evaluation exercises are provided and they are towards the end for self-check. I'm very happy to invite Nitin Pillai as a presenter for this online refresher course in English language teaching.
Thank you.
Nitin, I welcome you here.
Thank you very much, sir. Second language acquisition is a key part of any language theory. First languages are acquired naturally and very organically without much effort being put into it. However, when it comes to second language, a controlled environment needs to be provided to the students for them to be able to accept language.
Very true.
As you said, English is our second language for most of the speakers in India.
True.
Hence, it becomes mandatory that a teacher understands how second languages are acquired so that he or she can do this kind of an activity in class for better learning of the English language.
Very true.
Today, we will be discussing the module on theories of language learning, second language acquisition. Through this module, we would like to achieve the following objectives: to give a concise account of the theory and its propositions of diverse aspects related to second language acquisition, to draw light on recent researches on second language acquisition, thirdly, to discuss approaches and methods which are in practice related to second language. We will also be able to understand the process of L1 acquisition in terms of behaviorist, mentalist, and social interactionist theories of language learning. And lastly, the impact of the above theories on L2 acquisition. We will also try to find out the similarities and differences between L1 and L2. Before considering second language acquisition, it becomes necessary to understand language acquisition in simple terms. Language acquisition refers to any language in general, native language or second language. There is no learning process involved in it. Memorization or definition to be taken into consideration here because it happens very naturally. The only crucial need on the part of the learner is to analyze and decode the alphabets and words of a given language. It is in the 1960s that a deeper interest was taken into language acquisition. The linguist Stephen Krashen drew a clear difference between the term acquisition and learning in his theory of second language learning, which was published in 1982. He further brought into focus the term acquisition. According to him, learning language is concerned with the conscious aspects of language learning process, whereas acquisition refers to the subconscious facets. To unravel the ideology behind second language acquisition, we must first understand each word in isolation. These three words concerned are second, language, and acquisition. Second language here is the language which is learned or acquired after the first language, the native language or the mother tongue. The second language is the official language of the speaker's country or the state. Language is the method of expressing ideas and emotion in the form of signs or symbols. These signs and symbols are used to encode and decode the information. There are many languages spoken in the world. The first language learned by a child is his or her mother tongue. It is the language which he or she listens to from his or her birth. Any other language learned or acquired after this or in addition to this is known as the second language. For instance, a child who speaks Gujarati as a mother tongue starts learning English when he or she starts going to school. English is learned by the process of second language acquisition. According to Kleon, a language is the first and so is its acquisition if no other language was acquired before. Otherwise, it is second. Thus, the mother tongue which is acquired primarily by a child when his language cells are empty is first language, or as we call it, L1. And the language which is acquired or learned in addition to the L1 is called second language, or L2. In the book titled Understanding Second Language, Lodz Ortega defines second language acquisition as the scholarly field of inquiry that investigates the human capacity to learn languages other than the first during late childhood, adolescence, or adulthood, and once the first language or languages have been acquired. It encompasses the study of naturalistic and formal language acquisition in second, foreign, and heritage learning contexts. It seeks to understand universal, individual, and social forces that influence what gets acquired, how fast, and how well by different people under different learning circumstances. Therefore, second language acquisition in a broader sense depicts learning a second language. In summary, it is the name of the theory of the process by which we acquire a second language. Second language empowers the speakers for better opportunities for career and involvement with the society at large. At this juncture, we have to understand two crucial concepts, L1 and L2. In language teaching, we usually refer to L1, language 1, and L2, language 2, by defining it as follows. L1 is defined as generally the language acquired first or the mother tongue, which is also termed as MT. This is because it's usually the mother who speaks the most with the child and who establishes a regular and a lasting linguistic bond with the child. L2, on the other hand, is usually referred to that language which is learned after the mother tongue is acquired. That is to say, chronologically, the next language learned after the mother tongue. However, the concept of L1 determined by the context of learning throws up another definition which can be considered. According to Tove Skutnab-Kangas, a definition depending upon linguistic competence would be the language a person knows best. This sounds simple and unambiguous, where competence stands for skill, proficiency, or capability. This means that if I can use a language competently, that particular language becomes my mother tongue, MT. It is immaterial whether I am a native speaker of that language or not. For example, I may have learned Marathi first being a Maharashtrian by birth and being native speaker of Maharashtra, but in the state of Gujarat, if I can speak Gujarati competently in all spheres of life, then for all practical purposes, my mother tongue, MT, is Gujarati and not Marathi. This explanation also holds good for a more sociolinguistically oriented definition of L1, which states that L1 could be that language which the child uses the most. However, there are situations when people are using language at their workplace without knowing it fully well, as it is not their primary language. Another definition of L1 states the language one identifies with in the social realm. It means that the language through which in the process of socialization one has acquired the norms and value systems of one's group. For example, the Maharashtrian community internalizing the norms and values of the Gujarati community because of their stay in the state for a number of years. So, if you are looking in terms of origin, competence, function, and attitude, one can say that in a multicultural and multilingual country like ours, definition of L1 is not static but is continuously evolving because mostly all people in India are multilingual or at least bilingual. And use of mother tongue is likely to change depending on the situation and the different stages in your life. The question now arises whether it is possible to have two mother tongues. In a family where both parents have different mother tongues, then it is possible that the child will pick up both languages simultaneously because it is observed that the parents speak in their own mother tongue with the child. For example, if for a child the mother is a Punjabi and the husband is a Gujarati, then the mother will speak in Punjabi with the child and the father will speak to the child in Gujarati. In such a case, the child grows imbibing two linguistic systems simultaneously. When one language is spoken at home and the outside language is different, it is usually observed that a time comes when the outside language encroaches on the inside language and becomes the dominant language of a family. For example, a Malayalam speaking family residing in Madhya Pradesh where the societal language is Hindi. Malayalam is spoken at the home in the first few years of the child's life, but later on, a stage is reached when the child and the parents start speaking in Hindi at home instead of Malayalam. Similar is the case of an Indian family staying abroad in UK, Canada or US, where the societal language is English. Initially, the parents speak in their mother tongue with the child, but later on, a change occurs when English is being spoken with the children at home. The result is that a language more of English with interspersed with Malayalam words is spoken, leading to a loss of mother tongue language in the children and the parents as well. Second language, on the other hand, can be interpreted in different ways. One interpretation could refer to the chronology of learning the language learned. Second, that is, any language learned after acquiring the mother tongue. Learning of the second language can also take place at different stages in life. One, at an early stage when the language command is still rudimentary, and two, in the adult life when the L1 acquisition process is nearly complete or has slowed down considerably. Or it may take place in between these two points as well. Secondly, this term is used to refer to the level of language command in comparison to the primary or dominant language. In the second sense, second language indicates a lower level of actual or believed proficiency. Here, second also means weaker or secondary. As in many cases, the two uses coincide. That is, proficiency in a language acquired later than the L1 is frequently low than that in the L1. The term L2 is used to cover both the meanings. If the lower proficiency level is to be referred to specifically, the terms weaker or secondary can be used for clarification. Having understood the connotations of L1 and L2, let us now look at the various theories of learning and their impact on the teaching methodologies of English language. This brings us to the end of part 1. Part 2 will talk about behaviorist views on L1 acquisition and on second language.